Airships Conquer the Skies is an RTS game set in the steampunk era, where nations are at constant war with each other over land no one can afford to manage. Before you begin the game, you'll need to name your empire. I went with the glorious nation of Ecuador, while my friend chose the true capital of Britain, Manchester. Afterwards, you'll need to edit your coat of arms. The symbol you pick for your coat of arms will determine which buff you get. All of the buffs are good, but some of them are very good. When you enter the game, you'll notice that you're surrounded by many different nations. A thing to note is, there is no form of diplomacy, and therefore, every other nation should be treated as extremely hostile. So, where do you start? Well, find a nation you wish to start war with, build up a fleet, send said fleet into their territory, liberate said territory from your enemy's tyrannical rule, and assimilate them under your own tyrannical rule. Fun fact, often if your fleet is big enough, the enemy will surrender immediately. Finally, build defenses on your newly acquired territory so your enemies are less likely to take it back, and believe me, they will try.
Would you take away, Walter? I'm not having sex with you right now, Walter.
Besides other nations, there are miscellaneous threats around the map that you need to be careful of, such as pirates, mad scientists, giant bees, gargoyles, and many, many more. Some of these will sit on your land and put a strain on your economy just by being within your borders, but some of them will actively raid your cities for everything they're worth. More about these later. Everything you build is completely customizable, and there are four categories for customization: modules, armor, paint, and decoration. Modules and armor are primarily what your builds are made up of, and because of that, everything you add from these two categories comes at a cost, so what you're able to build is heavily restricted by your budget at the time. On top of what's available to you in the beginning of the game, better modules and armor can be acquired by investing in research. It's a slow and painful process that can only be sped up by burning an absurd amount of money. As an example, if you get the Empire of Science, you will virtually bankrupt your empire in the early game, but at least you'll have advanced metallurgy in a somewhat reasonable time frame. What does it do? Great question. My answer? Who cares? The final two categories are paint and decoration. Unlike the previous categories, these are purely cosmetic and completely free. With this in mind, I decided to make my ships look as obnoxious as physically possible, with the sole intent to piss off anyone who got to look at them. Now, everything you build is going to require a few things: a crew, which can be conjured into existence with barracks, berths, and etc., an ammo storage, which is needed for the majority of your weapons, a supply hatch or several supply hatches depending on the size of your build, and if you can afford it, a fire point, which can be necessary to prevent your enemies from succeeding with their frequent arson attempts. There are a few optional things I left out, such as guard barracks, med bays, and repair bays, and I did this on purpose because human life in this universe is extremely expendable. Entire generations are born and raised to fight until they inevitably perish in an effort to protect their nation's freedom and democracy. This is just a way of life for these people, and I feel it would only be disrespectful to introduce such heretical concepts such as safe working conditions and acknowledgement of human autonomy. Oh, and you remember those miscellaneous threats I mentioned in the beginning? Well, if you defeat them, you have a slight chance to gain some of their unique land and air units. These are impossible to acquire any other way, so it really provides a great incentive to weed them out. However, there is one threat that can't be weeded out so easily. If by some chance a mad scientist attempts to raid your town with these things called sky squids, just surrender immediately. Swallowing your pride is nothing compared to watching the sky squids swallow your entire crew before decimating your unmanned defenses. This game is very eventful, and a lot of fun. Just the general feeling of progression and gradually learning how to build with greater functionality was enough to have me hooked for hours at a time. However, it isn't without its flaws. One of the biggest flaws I was able to find was when you enter late game in a multiplayer server, many potential issues will come up, such as freezing and crashing. To make matters worse, it may take you over an hour's worth of attempts to relaunch the server, and it's probably just gonna crash again anyway. Now, this game is created and developed by one man, and with that in mind, I have some understanding of these issues. On top of that, there is also an update coming out very soon, possibly even before this video is up, and I have high hopes for it, as not only might it fix a lot of the bugs, but from what I've heard, it's going to be a massive overhaul update. And if this is the case, I'll likely be making a part 2 sometime after it comes out. So to wrap this up, Airships Conquer the Skies is an incoherent mess with clunky menus and a multiplayer function that is still in early development, but regardless, I love it with all my heart, and you most likely will too. I rate this game my IP address out of 10. Have a good one.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you.